Welcome to Disneyland, the happiest place on earth. We're pleased that you've chosen to visit us, and we hope this tape will make your visit an even more enjoyable one. My name is Jack, and it's my pleasure to be your host. Before you begin your journey, a few words about Disneyland in general. Disneyland is a first, an original. Since the day it opened in 1955, more than 100 million people have come here from the four corners of the earth to participate in adventures unique in all the world. Here, tomorrow is today, and yesterday is forever. Within the thematic realms of Disneyland are wonders of every shape and description, medieval castles and rocket ships of the future, explorer canoes and streamlined monorail trains, snow-capped mountains and colorful deserts, jungle elephants and flying elephants. All in all, Disneyland is over 50 major adventures and attractions showcased in seven different lands or realms. Adventureland, Frontierland, Fantasyland, Tomorrowland, New Orleans Square, Bear Country, and the land you presently are in, Main Street, USA. A land of warm, welcoming colors and old-fashioned Victorian-styled buildings, Main Street, USA is the first land to greet visitors to the happiest place on earth. Here, in an atmosphere of turn-of-the-century America, you can answer alarms in 1900-era fire engines, putter around in 1903 vintage automobiles with fringed canvas tops, enjoy riding open-air double-deck buses of the type used in major cities at the beginning of the century, or experience the fun of riding a real horse-drawn streetcar. Here, too, is a land wherein the sounds themselves convince one that the past indeed lives again. The rich harmonies of barbershop quartets, the bright spirited rhythms of marching bands, the easy listening melodies of town square concerts, and certainly most memorable of all, the hiss, chug, and puff of the old-fashioned iron horse and the station master's accompanying cries of "Port!" Main Street is also the home of the Walt Disney Story, a stirring, free attraction offering rare film footage showing the art of animation. Priceless memorabilia, nostalgic photographs and awards, skillfully displayed in a fitting tribute to the life and accomplishment of Walt Disney. This attraction is climaxed by Walt Disney's greatest audio animatronic achievement, Great Moments with Mr. Lincoln, which highlights numerous speeches of the great emancipator. Of course, no Main Street, be it young or old, would be complete without a variety of shops, stores, and restaurants, and Disneyland certainly obliges. Here, as you walk the length of this memory-filled land, you'll enjoy listening for the bongs and pings of an old-fashioned penny arcade, the spoon-against-glass tinkle of the once-common ice cream parlor, and the rinky-tink melodies emanating from Coca-Cola's refreshment corner. Even your sense of smell will remind you of a bygone era, of a time when freshly squeezed orange juice was a commonplace refreshment, of a time when the old-fashioned candy store was one of the most frequented places in town, of a time when fresh, hot popcorn was a popular street corner commodity. All this awaits you along Disneyland's Main Street, USA. Enjoy it and linger as long as you like. Just turn the tape player off when you hear this tone, and turn it on again when you enter Adventureland. We'll be waiting for you there. Welcome to Adventureland. As you've already noticed, the atmosphere here is quite a bit different from the land you've just left. Main Street's Victorian-styled buildings have given way to lush jungle greenery and thatched roofed huts of varying shapes and sizes. And the clip-clop of horses' hooves have given way to the rhythmic beats of jungle drums. One of Disneyland's most popular lands, Adventureland is the home of a variety of exciting shops and restaurants, all boasting an Asian, African, or South Pacific theme. It's also the home of two very popular attractions, the Enchanted Tiki Room and the Jungle River Cruise. We invite you to visit both of these fun-filled attractions, and to make your listening pleasure more enjoyable, we've provided descriptions of both. However, should you prefer to walk around a bit before entering either or both of these adventures, just shut this tape player off at the sound of the tone and turn it on again just before entering the Enchanted Tiki Room. The attraction you're about to enter, Walt Disney's Enchanted Tiki Room, introduced an entirely new form of three-dimensional entertainment when it opened in 1963. The new form is called audio animatronics, the Disney design system for animating inanimate objects. This development later made possible such popular Disneyland attractions as the Pirates of the Caribbean and the Haunted Mansion, among others. But many years of existence certainly hasn't diminished the Tiki Room's popularity. Located near the entrance to Adventureland, Walt Disney's Enchanted Tiki Room is a South Seas island adventure that features the singing of some 225 tropical birds, flowers, and tiki gods. And it's an adventure that takes no time at all to get started. Even before entering the Tiki Room itself, guests are given a taste of the tropical magic in store for them as tiki gods and goddesses in the Enchanted Garden introduce themselves and tell exciting legends of the South Seas. At least sometimes they're exciting. Other times they're a little strange. After meeting Koro and his other more enthusiastic god friends, Maui, Tangaroa Ru, Hina Kalu'ua, Tangaroa, Rongo, Pele, and Ngende, guests are ushered into the Tiki Room for one of the most unusual and colorful musical fantasies in Disneyland. As the lights dim and an eerie silence fills the thatch-covered hut, a tiny spotlight focuses everyone's attention on a multicolored parrot perched near the center of the room. Motionless up to this point, the bird appears to be either asleep or, of all things, stuffed. But he's neither. With a surprisingly loud sigh, even for a parrot, he nods his head, winks at the audience, and introduces himself as Jose, the master of ceremonies. From this point on, the show literally comes to life. Jose introduces fellow MCs Michael, Pierre, and Fritz, who in turn bring to life a ceiling's worth of multicolored, chirping, cheeping, whistling tropical birds, who bring to life a centerpiece's worth of beautiful white cockatoos, who bring to life 4 walls worth of singing, humming tropical flowers, who bring to life 4 corners worth of talking tiki gods and goddesses, who, along with everyone else just mentioned, bring to life so many haunting melodies and comical tunes that the entire tropical paradise is filled with music from top to bottom, corner to corner. It's a fun attraction, one which we're sure you'll enjoy, especially if I stop talking in your ear. So please turn the tape player off at the sound of the tone and turn it on again before you enter the Jungle River Cruise. If by now you've managed to stop singing like the birdies sing, we'd like to take this opportunity to welcome you to the Jungle River Cruise, what many consider to be Disneyland's finest achievement. It compacts into a 10-minute experience the highlights, the mystique, and the excitement of a true-to-life adventure that could only be duplicated through weeks and months spent in the great outdoors. Covering the Jungle Cruise's 5-acre waterways in sturdy boats, guests place themselves in the trusted hands of outspoken guides as they creep down rivers rarely traveled by the civilized world. Here, one encounters rich, mist-filled rainforests, crocodile-infested areas, pools filled with bathing pachyderms, the thundering Albert Schweitzer Falls, lion-filled grasslands, boat-charging hippos that are promptly shot at by your guide, and the rapids of Kilimanjaro. Of course, we don't want to spoil your fun by telling you everything you're about to experience. Besides, we think you'll find that your trusted guide will leave few things to your imagination, since he's got a smart remark for just about everything. So please turn off the tape player at the sound of the tone and turn it on again when you enter New Orleans Square. Welcome to yet another world filled with many different experiences, Disneyland's New Orleans Square. Here, Disney designers have reproduced the grand city of Louisiana in every minute detail. There are winding streets, ornate iron-trellised balconies, romantic courtyards, and exquisite gourmet restaurants. Even the quaint little shops that line the narrow avenues of this romantic land add to its charm and warmth. Lafitte Silver Shop, Christelle d'Orléans, Le Gourmet, and Mademoiselle Antoinette's Parfumerie, just to name a few. Of course, New Orleans Square is enhanced even further by a wide array of fragrant floral arrangements, small stands offering Creole delicacies, and strolling Dixieland musicians who wander through the narrow promenades playing authentic jazz. But maybe most important of all, Disneyland's New Orleans Square is also the home of the rowdiest group of pirates ever to plunder the Spanish Main, and the spookiest collection of unearthly pranksters ever to haunt a house on a hill. These are the residents and stars of the Pirates of the Caribbean and the Haunted Mansion, two of the most adventure-filled attractions in the happiest place on Earth. Here again, though, should you want to do some dining, shopping, or strolling before entering either of these attractions, please shut this tape player off at the sound of the tone. When you turn it on again, we'll give you a sneak preview as to what is in store for you in the Pirates of the Caribbean.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's life for me.
And that's exactly what's in store for you in Disneyland's Pirates of the Caribbean, a harrowing 15-minute experience of a pirate's way of life. Gunshots, cannon blasts, explosions, and all. Here, intrepid guests board boats for an almost true-to-life adventure on the Spanish Main. Sailing silently through a moonlit New Orleans bayou, guests plunge down two steep waterfalls and deep into an underground cavern, where they're greeted by several eerie reminders of the tumultuous buccaneer period. The thunder of rampaging waterfalls can be heard on every side. Skeletons hold sway over a mountain of pirate treasure, and a haunting voice issues an ominous warning of danger lurking ahead. And danger there is. Rounding a corner, guests are suddenly caught in a crossfire between a stone-walled fortress on the right and a cannonading pirate ship on the left, the latter complete with bellowing audio animatronics buccaneers and gunfire aplenty. After avoiding a barrage of flying cannonballs that land too close to their boats for comfort, guests next sail into a seaport town where a few rum-fuddled looters ransack and burn the community, chase after and auction off village maidens, and sing and laugh to the fetching tune, "It's a Pirate's Life for Me." And finally, with the cracking and popping of burning wood roaring all around them, guests sail in and thankfully quickly out of a storage room filled with gunpowder, cannonballs, and whiskey-filled gun-shooting pirates. Now we invite you to experience for yourself a pirate's way of life. And when you return, we'll preview for you yet another attraction awaiting you in Disneyland's New Orleans Square, the Haunted Mansion, a frightfully funny attraction indeed. Please turn this tape player off at the sound of the tone, and turn it on again before entering the Haunted Mansion. Happy sailing! We hope you enjoyed your tour of a pirate's way of life, and invite you now to tour a different form of life, a sort of unlife, so to speak. We invite you to visit our Haunted Mansion, haunted by 999 of the most fun-loving ghosts, ghouls, and banshees ever to immaterialize. Disneyland's most spirited attraction, the Haunted Mansion features not only its 999 floating, jumping, dancing residents, but also stretching rooms, creaking doors, and other little surprises guaranteed to send shivers up the spine of even the bravest visitor. But you're not left to shiver on your own. Disneyland even supplies an official ghost host to keep you company during your little journey, and he does a pretty good job. That is, if you like the kind of company you can hear but can never feel. And he takes no time at all to introduce himself. The moment you've entered the mansion's chilling parlor area, he begins his running commentary that will follow you wherever you go. Your first stop will be a large wood-paneled room that has no windows and no doors and seems to stretch right out from under you. You're next ushered into a long hallway that's lined with eerie paintings and flooded with the sound of violent thunderstorms. And then you're ushered into black-hooded doom buggies that will transport you into a world of unearthly delights never before imagined. Here, amidst a cacophony of creaks, groans, and moans, you'll pass down a hallway lined with doors that seem almost alive. move around a seance room filled with floating musical instruments and a bodiless head that controls their every move. Pass above a gathering hall wherein ghosts of every shape and description seem bent on dancing the night away. Drift through musty attics and stone-cold chambers, and finally venture into what turns out to be a very lively graveyard. As shadow-covered, eerie places go, Disneyland's Haunted Mansion is a gasp. So we hope you'll enjoy your visit. However, since the mansion's ghost host doesn't appreciate vocal competition, please turn off the tape player at the sound of the tone and turn it on again when you get to Bear Country. And good luck. Well, we're certainly glad you made it. Ever since the mansion opened, its occupants have been looking for resident number 1000. And we've always wondered who the person would be that would enter the mansion and never... But that's another story. Right now, our job is to welcome you to Bear Country. Bear Country brought a whole new woodsy look to the happiest place on Earth when it opened during the summer of 72. A light-hearted recreation of the Great Northwest, Bear Country is a pine-filled woodland that features themed food and merchandise centers, family fun adventures, and a rib-tickling Disneyland attraction called Country Bear Jamboree. A fast-paced country western music review laced with comedy and catchy tunes, Country Bear Jamboree stars 22 lifelike Northwest animals who sing, strum, and pun their way through a thoroughly entertaining 15-minute show. The MC of the show is a bear by the name of Henry, an amusing chap who stands 7 feet tall and wears a live raccoon hat. His job, like his mindedness, is simple. Keep the audience in stitches and introduce the stars of the show. However, the former he finds much easier than the latter. The first group to suffer through a Henry introduction after a short piano intro by Gomer, the only bear in the show who can play in a key other than C, are the five bear rugs, the unbearable band of the Bear Jamboree. After the bears in the band, a small mandolin-playing bear by the name of Wendell joins MC Henry for a couple of duets, sour-noting them to death to prepare the audience for Liver Lips McGrowl, who wails into a touching rendition of My Woman Ain't Pretty. Sharing the spotlight from this point on are such country western greats as Trixie, the lonesome loser, Terrence, the vibrating wreck from Nashville Tech, the Sunbonnet Trio, Bunny, Bubbles, and Beulah, Ernest the Dude, Teddy Barra, who descends from the ceiling on a flower-covered swing, and the one and only Big Al, whom you'll recognize immediately from the lousiest guitar playing you've ever heard in your life. Bear Country, featuring the hilarious Country Bear Jamboree, is all yours to enjoy. Spend as much time as you like. Just turn off this tape player at the sound of the tone, turn it on again when you get to the next land you'll be exploring, Frontierland. We'll be waiting for you there. Walt Disney, who was a dedicated student of American history, once said, "All of us have cause to be proud of our country's history, shaped by the pioneering spirit of our forefathers." Walt paid special homage to the brave pioneers in many ways, but perhaps his greatest tribute to America's early years stands today in Frontierland. Here, the United States, during the era when it was still a floundering young nation, has been recreated and preserved for all generations to appreciate. In this historical land, Bear Country's wooded natural surroundings give way to a rustic frontier town that is still in full operation. There are the flags of the original 13 colonies flying proudly over the log-walled stockade entrance to the land. The 1790 square-masted sailing schooner Columbia anchored at a nearby dock, and the stern-wheel steamboat Mark Twain slowly churning up a muddy river. Just up the street, mariachi bands periodically serenade guests in the courtyard of the enchanting Casa de Fritos Hacienda, which serves tangy Mexican dishes. And wooden sidewalks lead to the entrance of bustling frontier stores, where shoppers can purchase a complete line of woolen goods, ladies' apparel, and souvenirs. Also within earshot, high-kicking dancing girls, corny comedians, and deep-throated vocalists entertain guests in the old-fashioned brass-railed Golden Horseshoe Soft Drink Saloon. And just a stone's throw away is our newest attraction, Big Thunder Mountain Railroad, a whirlwind trip through towering rock formations, tumbling avalanches, and a roaring waterfall on the fastest and wildest railroad anywhere on the frontier. Eating, too, can be an adventure in Frontierland. Here, a guest may choose the Mexican cuisine of Casa de Fritos, specially prepared waffle and pancake treats of the Riverbell Terrace, or a vast assortment of hot and cold sandwiches featured at food stands distinctively designed to fit the Frontierland motif. This is the panorama of Frontierland, a composite of the life and times of 100 years ago, a return to the heritage of the Old West. A land we are sure you will enjoy. Please turn this tape player off when you hear the tone and turn it on again when you enter Disneyland's most magical land of all, Fantasyland. Now that you've enjoyed a taste of the life and times of the Old West, we'd like to welcome you to the happiest and most magical land in Disneyland, Fantasyland. Here, imagination rules supreme. As Walt Disney said, what youngster listening to parents or grandparents read aloud has not dreamed of flying with Peter Pan over moonlit London or tumbling into Alice's nonsensical wonderland? In Fantasyland, these classic stories of everyone's youth have become actual realities for youngsters of all ages to participate in. And participate you can. You can ride King Arthur's carousel, spin around in one of the Mad Hatter's teacups, race through the cobblestone streets of old London with Mr. Toad, travel in mining cars through the dark forest to the Seven Dwarfs diamond mine, or take a canal boat to a land where you'll find the miniature dwellings of famous storybook characters. Or, should you desire, you can visit the Upside Down Room, Garden of Living Flowers, and Tulgey Woods of Alice in Wonderland. Or fly an elephant high above the ground. Or ride the little train that could, the Casey Jr. You can even follow Tinkerbell and Peter Pan to Never Never Land. Or take a streamlined Skyway bucket from Fantasyland through Disneyland's towering Matterhorn Mountain to Tomorrowland. All these experiences await you in Disneyland's Land of Imagination. Fantasyland is also the home of Disneyland's most famous landmark, Sleeping Beauty's Castle. The beautifully decorated 146-foot-tall medieval castle serves as the gateway to a world of dreams and hopes. Hopes that perhaps are best realized in the happiest attraction of all, It's a Small World. But before we go on, we'll pause here and let you capture for yourself the feeling of excitement and fun that permeates this entire land. Then, when you're ready, we'll tell you a bit about the It's a Small World attraction. Please turn this tape player off when you hear the tone and turn it on again before you enter It's a Small World. We'll be waiting for you there. Welcome to It's a Small World, the most musical, lyrical, magical attraction in Disneyland. Here, 297 children native to 100 different nations and areas of the world are spotlighted as they serenade boat-borne guests with their meaningful song, It's a Small World. Brought to life by Walt Disney's sophisticated audio animatronic system, the starring children include ice skaters, bagpipers, mountain climbers, bell ringers, snake charmers, gauchos, magic carpet riders, and dancers from North America, Western Europe, Eastern Europe, the Middle East, Asia, Africa, Latin America, and the South Pacific. And to add a bit of local color to the whimsical festivities, Small World also features an entourage of pampered poodles, rambunctious goats, a Bengal tiger, smiling hippos, spindly giraffes, wild birds, fire-peaked volcanoes, mermaids, smiling tropical fish, a pink whale, and all sorts of other strange creatures of the deep. Outside the attraction's palace-like home, which boasts a facade trimmed in gold and white geometric shapes and historic landmarks from around the world, guests begin and complete their cruise by sailing beneath one of the most unusual clocks in the world. Towering some 30 feet above the ground, this imaginative timepiece actually performs the time every 15 minutes. The spectacle begins as a frenzy of sounds and activity. Gears, cogs, springs, and other clock paraphernalia come to life. Drums roll, trumpets blare, doors open, and suddenly, 24 figures of internationally costumed children, one for each hour, march forth in a gala parade of toys to announce the quarter hour being signaled by colorful numerals in the clock's doorway. Originally designed for the New York World's Fair and then redesigned, enlarged, and added to Fantasyland in 1966, the happiest cruise in Disneyland has created a world of laughter and fun for well over 40 million guests since its debut at the fair in 1964. It's a world where poodles, goats, hippos, giraffes, mermaids, a pink whale, and 297 children from nations all over the world join together to make people smile and remind them that really, it's a small world after all. We bid you bon voyage. Have a pleasant journey. Please turn off the tape player when you hear the tone and turn it on again when you enter the last land on our tour, Tomorrowland. Unlike Disneyland's other lands, which are tied to man's past or present, Tomorrowland is a glimpse into man's future, a chance for guests to experience where man is going and why. Here are any number of attractions that will provide guests with thrills never before experienced. For example, in Adventure Through Inner Space, guests have the chance to journey into the world of the atom, a world where snowflakes are towering mountains of ice, drops of water are swirling masses of molecules, and atoms themselves are as large as basketballs. Here, too, guests can board the futuristic Disneyland monorail train. America's first daily operating monorail system, Disneyland monorail trains take guests at treetop level in view of the park's main entrance, Submarine Lagoon, and Matterhorn Mountain as they travel the 2.5-mile beamway that links the park with the Disneyland Hotel. A transportation system of a different kind is the People Mover, featuring cars without motors, in which guests are treated to a high-level tour of Tomorrowland and a trip through the Super Speed Tunnel, where they can experience the breathtaking illusion of tremendous speed. Towering above Tomorrowland are the futuristic peaks of Space Mountain. Inside, Disneyland astronauts experience the thrill of a twisting, speeding journey past the stars and unexplored galaxies, bursting through a cosmic vapor curtain into the deep, dark void of super space, where time is non-existent and distances are spanned at infinite speeds. Or board a missile at McDonnell Douglas Mission Control for a flight to Mars. Find out what it's like to be an astronaut. Experience the pull of gravity and weightlessness as you hurtle through a dangerous meteor shower and a hyperspace warp on your way to the Red Planet. If you like to stay closer to Earth, then climb aboard the Swinging Carousel of America Sings, a magical joyride to Musicland, USA. Laughable members of the park's Animal Kingdom offer guests their unique renditions of traditional favorites of 200 years of American song. Other attractions featured in the Tomorrowland area include America the Beautiful, an attraction that takes guests on a tour of America in a theater whose screens and stereophonic sound literally surround the viewer. The Submarine Voyage, where guests can take a submarine on a journey to the North Pole. The Skyway to Fantasyland, which transports guests high above Disneyland from the land of the future to the happiest land of all. The Tomorrowland Rocket Jets, which guests can actually fly in a circular flight pattern some 60 feet above the ground. And one of the most popular adventures in Disneyland, the Matterhorn Bobsleds, which take guests on a chilling bobsled run through icy caverns, fog banks, eerie, colorful icicles and ice crystals, and a terrifying encounter with the abominable snowman, long thought to be hiding in the remote Himalayas of Asia. A visit to Disneyland's Tomorrowland is an exciting adventure, one that is rooted in the past, features the future, but can be enjoyed by everyone today. And as you enter this final Disneyland land, it's also an opportune time for us to say goodbye. We've enjoyed being with you and hope we've made your visit here at the happiest place on earth more pleasurable. Have a good time in Tomorrowland, and please turn this tape player off when you hear the tone and return it to City Hall when you're ready to leave. It's been our pleasure to entertain you, and we hope you'll come back and visit us again soon.